Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create curve pattern in Revit. As you can see on my screen here, just my previous pattern that I created. And of course, I know some of my subscribers and some of students and some of beginner level, they are struggling to create curve pattern. And I thought it would be interesting and I can create this tutorial for help them out. Anyway, as you can see on my screen here, and of course for my pattern, not only for curve pattern, but it's a parametric as well. And of course you can apply that for your facade design. Let me show you just a quick parametric first. Let's say I want to select my curve here. We count this one for number 2. And I take a look on my property panel there. I can change that. Let's say I want to make my wheel grid only 5. Okay, we make it for 8. And make our wheel grid there 8 or so. Then I can hit apply. As you can see, it's quite parametric. And of course, I will make it for bigger than that, 5 by 5, as you can see. And I can make it 2 by 2. Just apply. Okay, perfect, as you can see. And the joining is also properly for our pattern. And of course, for those some kind of pattern, you can apply for your facade also. For those facade design, let me change this one to 10, and okay, we make it for 5, and I make it for 5 again. Apply. When I look closely on my property there, I can saw here is a rectangle for family 3 for our model family. So I can go to the type there, got parametric inside also. Let's say I want to make my offset there bigger or big, I will make it for 150, then I can apply. So far we'll be generating, as you can see, it's more thickness than before. I can hit okay first. That's how we can create our pattern. So now let's speak into our project together, but I don't want to close that. I will leave it like this, and I will make it for 10 by 10 again. Here 10 by 10 again. Okay, perfect. Let's turn into our project together. I can go to Control N on my keyboard for shortcut key. Then I'm going to open another metric architecture template. It's okay. Okay, so after done, they will transform me to another page for Revit architecture template. But I think we should be close our previous pattern first. It's easier for us to recognize them. So now for a processing. Okay, so now Revit is transform me to another template for architecture template. Now I would like to close my previous one first. I don't want to save also. And there is our family also. I want to close also. Come on. Okay, so now it's time to create our curve pattern. By create that, I need to go to my file there. And go to new. Go to family. I'm going to using for generic model curtain best, I think. Generate metric curtain panel pattern best. I can hit open up. Okay, so now we read on our family. As you can see, we got 4 points there. The kind of 4 points is adaptive component actually. Then what I'm going to do for create our concrete pattern by using our curtain panel. I'm going to my reference plan there. Okay, so before I place my reference plan, I forgot already. I need to hit escape a couple of times first. I need to resize my curtain first. Actually, our panel size is for concrete block is around 300 or 400 only. Then I will give it for a specific size, 3365 by 365. Okay, perfect. Then when I zoom in closely, it's perfect. It's time to place our reference point. I'm going to my reference there and place point. Simply place for the center here. It has get a couple time. Again, go to our reference. Set a work plan. Set work plan like this. Make sure you turn off for 3D snapping. So I will using for rectangle for draw that. Start from here. I'm going to make it something about like this. Let me see first. Okay, let's get a couple time. Now it's time to resize our rectangle. I can select my first point there. And I will make it for 150. Okay, sorry, hit escape first. I should be select the top one. 150. And of course there also for our length also. Okay, then I want to delete the top one first. Okay, then select another side for our line here. Simply go to top here. As you can see, it's a point there. We drag our point until here for triangle set. Okay, perfect. It's time to assign for parameter for size. I'm going to create parameter. By create that, I can go to create tab or select align or DI for shortcut key for dimension. Then I can start from here and start to another guy, hit a tab key on my keyboard until I got the small point like this, as you can see here. Then now I can give a dimension. Let me rescale first. Okay, then for the top one as well, hit a tab key until I got my point like this, as you can see here. Then I can zoom here out like this, hit escape a couple time. It's time to create our parameter. I can select my dimension here and I'm going to give it for height. And there I'm going to give it for offset. Perfect. It's time to create our shape. I just select my triangle there and select my previous four component adaptive with reference plan. I can create form and select form. Okay, as you can see, it's perfect. Then I can select all here, go to filter, check none, curtain panel, apply. It's okay. The reason I select like this because I want to select only my curtain panel, easier for me for assign a new parameter. It's associate family parameter. Create new, then I'm going to give it for material. Just make it for material pattern. Yep. Okay, then it's okay. Then I'm going to family type. Family type sheet, I'm going to create a new family for material parameter. Create new family and quick name. Basically our concrete block is concrete. Now I want to make another texture, it's white. Let's say we make it for white pen. Appearance library. Wall pen here and choosing for cool white. Apply, then it's okay. Apply, it's okay again. Go back to my level one there. Now it's time to load our pattern to our project. I just load into project here. Okay, so now I read on my architecture interface. What I'm going to do next, I'm going to create some 2D line first before I'm placing my meshing and size for transfer my family to concrete pattern. I'm going to my architecture tab there and go to model line here or LI for shortcut key. I can start using for start out here, then start it around, let's say we start it around 3 meter, and I'm going to make curve here something like this. And another curve here, 3 meter as well, and make our curve like this. Hit escape a couple time. I can go to my mask, in place mask, then mask one, pick line, pick here one and two. hit escape a couple times, turn on for my 3D here, start from like here, I can select all like this, then CO for copy. I'm going to unconstrain first and copy that about 3 meter, hit escape a couple times. I think 3 meter is enough actually. Then I can select all, create form, solid form. Now we got our form for curve. What we need to do next, I'm going to device surface, just hit a tab key for select all device surface, and I'm going to change it for my previous pattern that we create. Just simply press that, as you can see. And there you can, as you can see here, we got some problem, but don't worry about that. Here we can flip that. I'm going to flip that. Okay, perfect. But I'm not happy about that because my pattern not quite nice. So how I can solve that? I just like my pattern there, then go to edit type here, and I'm going to change my height there only 120, and I can hit apply. As you can see, now got opening. If I want to make more opening, I just make it more smaller. It's apply. As you can see, it's, I want to make it more opening like that, just make it 50. It's quite parametric. Okay, once you done that, as I told you before, it's a parametric. You can change that by using our U grill and V grill for control that. Let's say I want to make it for 5, and by 5 I can apply. As you can see, 5 on column and 5 on row, and I want to make it smaller than that, I just make it 2 by 2. It apply. As you can see, it's quite realistic. And of course there I can change it for 10 and by 10 again. Okay, so now let's say I want to exact dimension for our concrete pattern. Here we just create for depend on our fixed number. Okay, so what I'm going to do in this case there, I'm going to hit finish first. Hit escape a couple times. I'm going to my level 1 again. Then I'm going to my architecture tab there. LI for 2D line. I'm going to apply that about 3 meter again. Okay, here, sorry. I'm going to LI again. And curve here, make it for 3 meter. And make it about like this. Make another guy 3 meter. And make another guy like this, hit escape a couple of times. Then I'm going to my 3D here. Okay, hit my 3D there. Then I can go to mask, implant mask. Then I can implant mask 2. Plus here, pick. I'm going to pick here 1 and 2. Hit escape a couple of times. Then I can select 2 of them like this. Let me see first. Okay, why very hard to see that? Okay, then start from back here. I'm going to copy that. Let me change this one to set first. CO for copy. Then I'm going to copy that higher than before. 3650, as I remember, is our curtain pattern height. And of course I just want to make it, let's say we make it around 3 meter or so. Don't want to make it too high. CO for copy, then unconstrained, start from here, make it for 3 meter or 4 meter I think. Then I can escape a couple of times first, then I can select all, same as before, we just simply create form. We got surface here, then I'm going to device surface, hit a tab key for select all, device surface again, then change from foot number to foot distance, change from foot number to foot distance, make it for 365 by 365, same as our panel in our family. Apply. Okay, perfect. So I'm going to place my element CM on my keyboard by plus 1 by 1 like adaptive component. I'm going to plus here. OK, Okay, hit escape first because I need to open node. I just like here, then open node here, node. Okay, and then this guy also. Go to arrow here, node. Okay, then CM for plus element. I'm going to plus from the bottom one here, one, second two, and third three, and four. Hit escape a couple time. I just repeat process, then repeat process. As you can see, now we got our curve pattern. And again, there I'm going to apply same thing. I just see again. Then I'm going to apply there. One, two, three, four. Then I'm going to add again. Okay, as you can see, it's quite thick. And the smaller one, let me try to press first, see we can press or not. We're going to see them again, then we try to press together, see if we can press that or not. Okay, basically cannot, as you can see, it's not realistic. Okay, here when you start to create those curve with exact size, you might be need to play around a little bit more because you need to remember how high for your family here and how big is your pattern here for panel there. You need to play around with that until you got that, or you can simply create like mine before. We just apply that, and of course there is how you can create your pattern with curves in Revit. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. I hope you got learned something new about that. Thank you for watching and thank you for joining me from start to finish, and for subscribe for long time and start subscribing today. Thank you for watching. See you for another tutorial in Revit, and have a nice day waiting to another future tutorial together. Thank you.